It had been a day of make-believe. Katie learned that if you pretend you can fly, you still need to have your feet on the ground. Or be found out that if you pull a rabbit out of your earmuff, the picture of the rabbit has to be small. And they both discovered that when you sprinkle a pink gnome with fairy sparkles, it's better to do it outside. As the fairy's mother says, it's hard to vacuum up sparkles. After lunch, Mom asked the two friends if they would please play outside while she did some house cleaning. Orby was delighted and hurried to dig his soccer ball out of the basement. In the basement, he had to lift things out of the way to find the soccer ball, things like Christmas tree stands and boxes and bags. One bag fell over, and a wondrous thing rolled out of it. It was a glittery silver ball. Orby looked at it as it lay shimmering on the floor. It was beautiful. He lifted it up and saw his upside-down reflection in it. And slowly he turned the ball, mesmerized by how it sparkled in the light. He hurried to ask Mum if he could play with the ball. Mum said it was an old plastic Christmas tree ball it was fine to play with, as she didn't use it anymore. Delighted, Orby carried the ball as if it was made of fine china out to the backyard. Arthur and Yi Ping had joined Katie. They were just discussing what to play when Orby came out carrying a ball. They hurried over to see. Orby told them it was a magic ball. The friends beamed. The game was obviously going to be magic wishes. Katie brought out the wicker costume basket. She handed Orby a long cape and a wizard's hat. Orby gently set the ball into the gap between the slats in the table so it wouldn't roll off. He pointed a wiggling finger at Arthur and told him that he would have the first wish. Arthur thought for a moment and then said that he wanted to ride a bucking bronco. Yi Ping didn't know what a bronco was, so Arthur explained that it was a wild horse. Orby swished and swooshed his hands around and over the ball, pretending to make magic. He burbled to the ball that it should make Arthur ride a bucking bronco. Orby then aimed wiggling fingers at Arthur. Arthur stared for a moment, and then he made his body jump. He grabbed the cowboy hat from the costume basket. The girls clapped in delight as he took off around the yard, galloping and kicking up his feet and holding onto his cowboy hat. Arthur was terrific, and Orby nodded gleefully. Next, he pointed his silly finger at Katie. Katie walked over to the magic glitter ball wizard. She asked that she be turned into a wonderful ballet dancer who could literally leap up over the top of a house. Orby did his swishing and swooshing and then aimed his wiggling fingers at Katie. She jumped up, threw on a tutu, then zipped into the house and out again with a tiny toy. She placed it on the grass and then began to dance, turning and swaying and revving up for a big leap. With the grace of a gazelle, she leapt over the toy. And when Yi Ping got closer, she saw that the toy was a tiny toy house. She and Arthur clapped, and again, Orby nodded his head. He was good. At last, it was Yi Ping's turn. She asked the ball to help her climb a tree without using her hands. Orby swished and swooshed and aimed wiggling fingers at her. Yi Ping stood there for a minute. She then waved Katie and Arthur over to the tree. They needed to hold on to her as her feet walked up the tree trunk. Well, I have to say, as her friends struggled to hold her there, the giggling turned to laughing. And within a few seconds, the entire cluster of friends collapsed into a laughing heap on the ground. But Yi Ping had walked up a tree. Orby nodded and smiled proudly. Making magical things happen was lots of fun. That night at dinner, out on the picnic table, Katie and Orby talked about their day. Orby explained that he and the ball were truly magical. Katie wished they were magical enough to find her coloring pad. She'd lost it. While the family munched on macaroni salad, Orby swooshed and swished and he looked right into the beautiful glitter ball. After thinking really hard for a moment, he told Katie It was under the couch. Katie asked to be excused and raced in to see if it was. And I know it's surprising, but when she looked, it was. When Katie reported her success, Orby nodded. He and the ball were amazing. Dad smiled. Mom wished she could find her missing garnet earring as easily. Well, Orby swished and swooshed again. It was caught between the bed and the bedside table, he burbled. Mom giggled, and then she asked if she could be excused too. After all, she had never looked there. Up in her room, she pulled the bedside out. And I know it is really astounding, but there, sitting all by itself, was the little earring. Outside, when Mom told of her success, Dad was astonished. Then the doorbell rang. They heard it through the kitchen door. Immediately, Orby predicted that it was Tom with a surprise. Well, the whole family was curious to know if Orby was right. Katie raced through the house to find out. When Mrs. Perrette came out with Katie, who was telling her all about the glitter ball, Orby was stunned that he was wrong. It wasn't Tom at all. He looked at the ball. It didn't seem to glitter so brightly. Orby sat down on the picnic table. He and the ball weren't so magic after all. Mrs. Perrette, who was carrying a basket, told Orby that magic came from the heart, not from the ball. Orby shook his head. After all, he'd been wrong. He wasn't Tom. Mrs. Perrette had to agree, but then she opened up a basket of tiny kittens. Katie looked from the kittens to Orby. The kittens certainly were a surprise. Orby looked at the smile on Katie's face, and maybe he was still a little magical after all. Mrs. Perrette kissed Orby and told him that everybody has a little magic in them. And do you know, she's right. There is a little magic in everybody. Even though you may not think so, I just happen to know that there is a little magic in you, too.